Now, so in this arithmetical operations, addition, subtraction is finished. Now the next instructions are incrementing and decrementing operation. Increment. Increment generally meaning is adds one. Okay, one is added with any register or sometimes memory location data, all this, right? So this incrementing operation purpose, here we are using one syntax. The syntax is INR, INR space R. Okay, so what is the meaning of this one? Increment register. Increment register. So what is the operation? The register data adds with 1 and the result is stored into register only. Okay, increment register means register data adds with 1 and the result is stored into register. So one example, INR B. Okay, now assume B register data is, I am assuming 56H. 56H. Then I am performing this operation. So this operation explains B register data adds with 1 and the result is stored into B register only. Here register only, not accumulator. Okay. So according to this, 56 is adds with 1. Then what is the result now? 57H. So after this operation, B register data is 57H. Okay, after this operation, B register data is 57H. Right? So this means increment means only adds one to the register. Now the complete operation is within the register. So it is comes under register addressing mode. Okay, and number of byte. How many byte? 1 byte is enough because there is no data is mentioned here. 1 byte instruction. And number of mission cycles. 1 mission cycle is enough because complete operation is within the processor only. So that mission cycle also fetching. The number of T states are 4 T states. Okay, similarly, DCRR. What is the meaning of DCR? Decrement. Decrement register. So decrement register performs the subtraction with 1. 1 is subtracted from the register and the result is stored into register. Same operation, now subtraction operation. Incrementing means plus 1 and decrementing means minus 1. Right? So same I am writing here. This is register addressing mode. So 1 byte instruction, complete operation within the register. So 1 mission cycle and number of T states are 4 T states. INR R, DCR R. Okay. Similarly, INR M. So M indicates the HL pair location data. Right, so HL pair location data. Now the HL pair address location data is adds with 1 and the result is stored into again HL pair address location only. Is it okay? Again the result is stored into that place. So now it performs the reading operation and writing operation. See, I am taking one example. HL register is a general example. I am taking again 2000H. This is address location. Okay. Now this is our complete memory. This complete memory. At this memory, some address location is I selected here 2000H. So in this some data is there. What is the data? Let us assume 35H. Right. Now I am writing instruction is INR M. This instruction I am writing here. For this instruction, what happens here? first it performs the reading of this. First it has to read the data. What is the data? Memory read. Now it reads the data. Right? This data performs the addition with 1. Now the result is 36H. Again, this data is stored into HL pair address location. So this data is stored into again here. So now it performs which operation? Memory write. See, one memory read, one memory write. Two extra mission cycles are required. One mission cycle is compulsory, fetching is must. Right? So now M is there, so it is comes under indirect addressing mode. Right? So indirect addressing mode, then number of byte instruction. 1 byte instruction is enough because your data is not mentioned. Then the number of mission cycles are 3 mission cycles. Why 3 mission cycles? One is fetching operation, another is memory read, next memory write. So memory read, first reading operation, later it performs the addition. The result is stored into memory write operation. Fetching, memory read, memory write operation, 3 mission cycles. So number of T states are now 10 T states because fetching is 4 T states. Okay, memory read is 3 T states and memory write also 3 T states. So now completely 10 T states. Right? Similarly, same similar operation DCRM. DCRM. So this explains HL pair address location data subtraction with 1. So 1 is subtraction from the HL pair address location and the result is stored into again HL pair. Right? Result is stored into again HL pair. Now I am writing here this operation is indirect addressing mode. Then 1 byte instruction set. Next, how many mission cycles? 3 mission cycles, similar to same. And number of T states are 10 T states. Okay, number of T states are 10 T states. These operations, incrementing and decrementing operations. Now here we discussed incrementing and decrementing operation. Here we have to remember one point here. Incrementing or decrementing or, right? And incrementing memory location. Okay, next decrementing memory location. These instructions does not affect on the carry flag. So for these instructions, carry flag is not affects. This is another important part. Okay. Especially these instructions. These instructions does not affect on the carry flag. So carry flag is not affects here. For INR, DCIR and INRM and DCRM. This is one of the important point here. Is it okay? So, right. Similarly, in this one more instruction also there, that is INX. INX space register pair. See, RP is given now. RP is mentioned. RP is mentioned means it is a register pair. Register pair. Okay. So now what happens here? Register pair data adds with 1 and the result is stored into register pair. Right? Register pair data adds with 1, result is stored into register pair. One example I am taking here. INX B. See, just observe in this instruction. Here we mentioned B only. Right? But here I am writing register pair because in this instruction X is given here. So in instruction mnemonic consists X, then that operation performs with the register pair. So now which register pair it takes here? BC. Okay? BC register pair data adds with 1, the result is stored into BC. right? So indirectly, which performs the which type of operation? How many bit operation? 16 bit operation. See, your B 8 bit and C also 8 bit. These 8 bit and these 8 bits are adds with 1 and again result is stored into BC. So indirectly it takes the 16 bit bus. But our 8085 microprocessor is 8 bit microprocessor. Internally it has 8 bit bus only. But internally it takes a B register extra. That's why it takes here bus opcode fetch. This is one special operation. Bus opcode fetch. Bus opcode fetch takes how many T states? 6 T states here. Okay. Bus opcode fetch takes here 6 T states. This is one of the very, very important point. Then this complete operation is within the register. So I'm writing here register addressing mode. Then number of byte. How many byte? 1 byte instruction only. Because internally only there is no data is mentioned. Then how many mission cycle? 1 mission cycle, because complete operation is within the processor. Then that mission cycle is how many T states? 6 T states. Okay, 1 mission cycle, but number of T states are 60 states. So here why 60 states? Because it performs the bus opcode fetch operation. So internally BC register, indirectly it uses the 16 bus locations. So extra 2 T states are required here. That operation is also called as bus opcode fetching operation. Okay. Now similar to this one, one more operation, DCX. DCX register pair. So DCX register pair, same operation. Subtraction 1 with the register pair here. Okay, 1 is subtracted from the register pair, result is stored into register pair. Now 1 byte instruction, 1 mission cycle, number of T states, 60 states. Right? So in the instruction X is mentioned, then it performs the operations with register pair. See here, we are taking RP means, one is B, another is D, and H and PSW. These are the names we have to mention in the instruction. Here B means BC register, D is D register, H HL register, and PSW accumulator and flag register. These are the register names. Okay, but here we have to mention only B, D, H or PSW, right? This X explains the it is a register pair operation. Okay, now one more important point here. The important is INX and DCX. INX and DCX. These two instructions does not affect on any flag here. So no flags are affected. No flags are affected. Means INX, DCX. These two instruction does not affect on the flags. So all the flags are 0 only. So after this operation, all the flags default operation is 0. It does not affect on the flags. Is it okay? So we can write here like this. No flags are affected. Is it okay? This is also another important point here. Okay. So in this another special instruction, DAD space RP. So DAD explains the double addition. DAD explains the double addition. So the double addition with the register pair, right? Which register pair? Default register pair is always HL register pair. So HL register pair data is addition with the register pair, given register pair. Then the result is stored into HL register pair. See, I am taking one example. That example is DAD B I mentioned here. So what is the meaning of B? BC register pair. Then how to find out whether it is BC or B? So using this operation, double addition. Double addition is always performs with a register pair only. So HL register pair is adds with the BC register pair. The result is stored into again HL register pair. This is one special operation, double addition operation, right? So number of bytes here, 1 byte, because there is no data mentioned in operand, so it occupies only 1 byte. But mission cycles are 3 mission cycles. Takes how many mission cycles? 3 mission cycles, because here we have to perform one operation, 8 bit operation, again 8 bit operation. So indirectly, which performs the how many bit operation here? 16 bit operation, right? So it takes more time. The time is here 3 mission cycles. So number of T states are 10 T states. Right? Now, up to now we discussed here arithmetical instruction set. So which performs the only arithmetical operations? Those operations are addition, subtraction, incrementing and decrementing operations only. Now the next instruction set is logical instruction set. So logical instruction set which performs the logical operations. Those operations are AND operation, OR operation, NOT operation and XOR, and one more is comparison. So these operations we are using here. Okay. AND, OR, NOT, XOR, comparison. All these are comes under logical instruction set here. Right. So now first we will start with AND operation. AND operation syntax is ANA space R. ANA space R. AND operation accumulator. Okay. Indirectly here also accumulator is default register. So which performs the AND operation. This symbol is AND operation symbol, intersection symbol, right? Which performs the AND operation of register, accumulator and register. Again the result is stored into accumulator, right? Accumulator is performs the AND operation with the register data, and the result is stored into accumulator. Okay, then number of byte instruction is 1 byte, because there is no data mentioned. Then how many mission cycles? 1 mission cycle is enough, because the complete operation is within the processor. Then the number of T states are 4 T states, because it's a fetching operation only, right? Similarly, here I'm discussing ANI, right? ANI 8-bit data. See, already we discussed the arithmetical instruction set, right? So arithmetical instruction set and logical instruction set, here same, similar to arithmetical instruction set, means performing register operation and immediate data, number of mission cycles, all these are similar to arithmetical instructions. Only the syntax is changes, because here which performs the logical operations, right? Only syntax is changes here. The syntax is here like this. Accumulator is performs the AND operation with 8-bit data. Now 8-bit data is directly is given. Result is stored into accumulator. Okay. Then this is how many byte instruction? 2-byte instruction. Number of mission cycles are 2 mission cycle, because immediate data is there, immediate data, right? And number of T states are 7 T states. Okay, number of T-states are 7 T-states. Similarly, one more operation with memory. With memory, what is the syntax? ANA, because we have to use here only ANA, accumulator. Okay, AND is for advanced processors. ANA space M. What is the meaning of M? M is here HL pair location data. HL pair location data is performs the AND operation with accumulator. Result is stored into accumulator. Okay, then see any extra byte is given here. So no extra byte is given. So it comes under 1 byte instruction set. Number of mission cycles are 2 mission cycles. What are those 2 mission cycles? One is fetching operation and another is memory read, because it has to perform memory read. So number of T states are 7 T states. Right. So similarly, OR operation is, see, AND operation, OR operation, NOT operation and XOR operation. All these operations are bitwise operations, because every bit it performs the operations, right? So now OR operation here. So which performs the OR operation? Any one input is 1, output is 1 here. If all the inputs are 0, then only output is 0. That operation. So that operation symbol I'm explaining here, union symbol, because OR operation is similar to union. Now similar to your AND operations, all these operations same operation, just syntax we are changing here. ORA explains the OR operation accumulator with this operand. What is operand here? Register. So accumulated data, register data, both performs the OR operation. Result is stored into accumulator. Okay, result is stored into accumulator, then it is comes under 1 byte instruction, because there is no data here. Then 1 mission cycle and 4 T states. Is it okay? Similar to your AND operation, this operation, similar to this operation. Right, only one is changing. Which is changing? Just syntax. Here we are performing OR and here it is a AND operation. Right, similarly, OR operation with immediate data. Immediate data, how many bit data? 8 bit data. So 8 bit data and accumulator, both performs the OR operation. Result is stored into accumulator. Then this is stored into accumulator only. Now it is 2 byte instruction and 2 mission cycles, 70 states. Now OR operation with memory location, accumulator and HL memory location, result is stored into accumulator. 2 byte instruction, sorry, it is a 1 byte instruction, right? It's 1 byte instruction, because OR operation, there is no data here. So 1 byte instruction, 2 mission cycles, 70 states. Now listen here, similar to OR operation, XOR operation. XOR operation is comparison, right? So 2 bits are same, the result is 0. 2 bits are different, result is 1. So that operation is numerics is XRA. XOR operation of accumulator with register, with operand, any one operand, sometimes register, sometimes 8 bit data, sometimes memory. So now accumulated data performs the XOR operation with register, result is stored into accumulator. Okay, so now 1 byte instruction set, 1 mission cycle, 40 states. Similarly, XOR operation with immediate data. So immediate data, again result is stored into accumulator. So immediate data is mentioned, so it is a 2-byte instruction set. 2-byte instruction set. Now it has to perform IO read operation, 2 mission cycles, number of T states are 7 T states. Right? Now XRAM, accumulator is performs the XR operation with the HL pair, and the result is stored into accumulator. So it is a 1-byte, 2 mission cycles, number of T states are 7 T states. These are XOR operation, same similar to your AND operation only. AND operation, OR operation and XOR operation, all these are similar. We have to change syntax, and internal operation is OR and XOR, right? And similarly, we have another logical instruction, comparison instruction. See, comparison instruction syntax is used here, CMP. Okay, CMP, which compares the two operands. Those two operands are, just I am writing one example, CMP space R. CMP space R. Comparison of accumulator with a register. See, in subtraction operation, register data subtracted from the accumulator and the result is stored into accumulator. So accumulator affects there. But in comparison operation, just indirectly which performs the subtraction, but the result is not stored into accumulator. So accumulated data, register data, it maintains the same data only. Okay, so those data are not affects here. Then how to find out, so how to compare, means how it performs the comparison operation, like using flags. Using flags. See, after this operation, flags affects here. Which left flags? Let us assume. Okay, let us assume here. One I'm thinking accumulated data is there, register data is there. So initially I'm assuming accumulated data is less than the register data. So I'm performing comparison operation. Internally, if the accumulated data is less than the register data, then it affects on carry flag. Carry flag becomes 1 and 0 flag is 0 only. Okay, so mainly it affects on these two flags, right? Accumulated data is less than the register data, carry flag is set 0, 0 flag is 0. If both are equal, carry flag is 0, carry flag is resets only, but 0 flag sets. 0 flag sets. If suppose accumulated data is register greater than the register data. So three types of operations are possible here. One is less than, equal, greater than. Accumulated data is greater than the register, then carry flag is 0, then jet flag is also 0. Is it okay? See, according to the flag status, we have to assume either accumulator or register data. Anyone is greater here. See, both are not affecting. Carry flag is not affecting and zero flag is not affecting. That meaning is accumulated data is more and register data is less. Only zero flag is affects. Then we have to assume both register data is same. Okay. And only carry flag is affects. Zero flag is zero only. But carry flag becomes 1. Then accumulator is less. Right? So according to three operations, any one flag here affects here. So from the flags, we have to understand the three concepts here. One is A is less than the R, A is equal to R, A greater than the R. This instruction is explained by comparison. Right? So similar to the previous operations, here also we have three relations are there. Okay, three relations. Just I'm writing those three relations. One is CMP R. What operation here? Which operation it performs? Accumulated data minus register. So result is not stored into accumulator. Okay. Now how many byte instruction? Same similar to your previous operation. 1 byte instruction. Total operation is within the processor. 1 mission cycle. That mission cycle number of T states are 4 T states. Okay. Similarly, CMP M. Now accumulated data compares with a HL memory location data. Right? It is again 1 byte instruction. Number of mission cycle, how many mission cycles? 2 mission cycles, right? Because 1 mission cycle is for memory reading operation. And number of T states are 70 states. Then another also there, CPI 8 bit data, immediate. Right, CPI 8 bit data immediate. Now the accumulated data is compared with the 8-bit information. 8-bit information. Okay. Now this is 2-byte instruction and 2 machine cycles, and number of T states are 7 T states. See, all these 4 operations are similar operations only. AND, OR, XOR. And here another important point is, okay, AND operation, OR operation, XOR operation. Okay, AND operation, OR operation, XOR operation. After these 3 operations, carry flag is always 0 only. Carry flag is always 0. What is the meaning of that one? Carry flag does not affect here. After these 4 operations, carry flag does not affect. It becomes 0. Because logical operations, number of bits means it gives the result is also number of bits, same bits only. Okay, it does not give the any extra bit. So that's why carry flag is always 0 after this operation. Not comparison. Comparison is affects on the carry flag. Right? So only this operation, ANA, ORA, XRA, means AND or XR. These 3 operations, carry flag is always 0.